What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose you are given an array of integers representing daily temperatures, and you were asked to return another array of the same size, such that the element at index I in that array represents the number of days you must wait after the ith day to get a warmer temperature. If there is no future day for which this is possible, keep the answer at the index equal to 0. To visualize the problem, take this array of temperatures as an example alongside the answer array initially empty. You see, on the first day at index 0, we must wait 2 days or 2 indices to get a higher temperature or bigger number than the one we are currently at. So, inside the answer array, index 0 will hold the value 2. Same goes for the second index, and the third will be 0 since there is no bigger number in the array. This same logic is repeated on all elements until we reach the last index, which will be always 0 since there are no values following that index. Now, to solve this problem, the first solution that may pop in your mind is traversing the array twice with the help of two nested loops. Notice how the second loop starts at the current index because we only need to check the elements that come after the current element. So, for each element inside the array, we will loop over the numbers that come after it until we reach a higher value, meaning until we find a solution, hence there is no need to continue with the inner loop. When we find a bigger value, we store the index difference in the result array and return that array to the user when the outer loop ends. Okay, this solution works, but usually, that is not what the interviewer is looking for, as in its worst case, it may be n squared in time. You see, a lot of iterations can be saved if you notice one particular property in this array, which is monotony. What do I mean by that? Well, let's bring back the same array we had. Notice how the second element is smaller than the first one, meaning that it is not a valid solution for it. But it also means that, as soon as we find the first value that is bigger than the first element, we can make use of the same value as a solution for the second element, right? And from here, we can start to notice the monotony I was talking about. The elements inside the array will keep decreasing in value, and as soon as that monotony breaks, meaning we found a bigger element, the breaking element will be the solution to one or several of the values preceding it. This can also be observed in the resulting array, where the monotony is preserved as you can see in front of you. Now, to reduce the time complexity of this algorithm, and as usual, we will have to consider a time-space trade-off. So, if our array is decreasing monotonically, we will take the elements we traversed and store them in some data structure. Then, as soon as the monotony breaks, we will start retrieving these elements one by one to check if that breaking element is a valid solution for the value at hand. And one of the data structures that we can use here to store these elements is the stack. Now, because this stack stores elements that are monotonically decreasing in our case, then this stack is called a monotonic stack. Monotonic stacks contain all the qualities a typical stack has, but its elements will all be monotonic, decreasing, or increasing. You see, whenever a problem requires you to enumerate values for indices based on other values in an array, you should think of including a stack in the solution. Let's visualize what the same solution would look like if we made use of a stack. As you can see, at any point in time, the elements inside the stack are decreasing in value. The top element will always be the minimum value in the stack, allowing us to pop it as soon as we find a bigger value, which is the solution in our case. The monotony is preserved at all times, as no value is inserted into the stack if we have elements that are smaller than it inside the stack. To implement this solution, let's start by creating the answer array we will be returning and an empty stack. Then we will need to traverse the array of temperatures given, the number of elements inside this array represents the total number of days we were given. With each traversal, we will be storing the index or day of the temperature we traversed inside the stack, as the problem wants us to find the day difference and not the next warmer temperature. However, before doing that, we will retrieve from the stack all the values that are smaller than the current value we are standing at, because if they are smaller than the current temperature, it means that this value is a valid solution for them. As soon as this condition is not satisfied, we can safely push the current day into the stack, and the stack will remain monotonic, because we know that this temperature is now smaller than the one at the top of the stack. So, inside the while loop and while retrieving each value, we will set the appropriate answer corresponding to it with the help of the same formula we used in our n squared solution. And that's it. Note that the solution we just wrote is derived from a typical template that uses the monotonic stack as a solution, and what you can see in front of you is the template I am referring to. So, we start by initializing an empty stack at the beginning. The stack will contain the index of items in the array or the items themselves depending on your use case. The code will be represented by an outer for loop and inner while loop. At the beginning of the program, the stack is empty, so we don't enter the while loop at first. The earliest we can enter the while loop body is during the second iteration of the for loop, when there is at least an item in the stack. At the end of the while loop, the index, or the current element itself, is pushed into the stack, and the operator inside the while loop condition decides what type of monotonic stack we are creating. Whether strictly increasing, increasing, strictly decreasing, or decreasing, meaning the operator could be any of the four, smaller than sign, smaller than or equal, bigger than or equal. By comparing this template to our code, you can clearly see that the sections we just covered all figure out and that we specifically applied the decreasing template, as inside the stack we may have two equal temperatures and a value is considered a solution when an element strictly bigger than the top is found. So, that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.